We are going to show a process called a image transfer process. And it's basically how to put images on wood. The reason I like to work with this technique is because the images look like they are printed on wood. You take a copy, a color copy, like this, and you basically glue it to a piece of wood. After it has been sitting overnight, you wash off the paper and the image stays in the wood. After that, you can put some finish on it and you have what looks like a printed image. These are actually finished pieces with the image transfer technique utilized on the inside. So it's an image of birds that have been transferred in. What I want to show is how to do this. To cut 5 pieces of veneer. And one rule that's actually really important is the uneven number. You never want to have 2, 4, 6, or 8 because that creates even pressure and tension, so it can actually delaminate. You want an uneven number. What I'm using is a glue called Unibond. It's a resin and a hardener glue. I put this on with a roller. It spreads much, much easier than any kind of glue spreader. There we go. Make sure you hit all the edges and all the corners. You don't want any dry spots, especially if you're going to cut into it, because then all of a sudden you can hit a dry pocket and it'll start delaminating. Okay, so I have 3 layers right here. You have to pay attention to how you want it to look, because with this veneer, the grain is going this way on one side and along on that side. So I center it and then go ahead and bend. So it's ready to go into the bag. The next thing you want on there is a piece of netting like this. And this is what disperses the air and makes for even pressure. If you don't put anything on there, this port is just going to suck down, and it'll be just like when you take your vacuum cleaner and, you know, you make a seal. Okay, so I'm going to slip this into the bag here.
The vacuum bag is essentially a polyurethane bag that you put wood in, and it sucks all the air out of the bag, and then the bag presses down on whatever wood you've got in there. So if you've got a form, like a solid form, you can bend wood over that form. So by pulling all the air out, the bag is doing the clamping.
And I put the port in the center, turn the pump on, and when it starts to press down, I sort of push it down to make sure that the bag doesn't sneak under the ends. It takes a couple of minutes for it to sort of suck out the excess air in here.